Hi, welcome to RoboJax. In this video, we are going to see how we can use this 2-channel 5-volt relay for Arduino to control an AC load and a DC, or maybe with a combination of both AC or both DC, like this. So now the load will be on, and then the motor will be on alternatively. Keep in mind that when you are connecting this to AC load, do not touch this area or this area. If you're working with this, you have to have proper protective gloves, and also make sure that you do not leave it on a surface that is metallic or conductive. So this is the relay, the size you can see it in my hand. We have two relays. Each relay has these three contacts. So these three contacts, the three contacts belong to this relay, and this relay has these three contacts. These contacts are named as normally connected, this and this. So if you connect a wire here and here, it will be normally connected. So the wire will be connected and pass through. But if you connect it in here and here, the middle one and the other one, so this is normally open and only will switch when it receives the signal. Same thing for this one. So you can connect two different AC or DC loads separately to control. And here we have four connections here. So let me hold it. Yes. So now we have four connections. On this side it says VCC, and here is a ground. So you connect this to 5 volts, presumably from Arduino. So Arduino has 5 volts, and this connected to the zero or the ground. And then we have N1 and N2. So N1 means input one for this relay, that's relay number one, and input two, that's for relay two. For each relay we have two lights here. So this is for the input two light. When it receives a signal, this will lit, informing you that there is a signal. And when there is a signal for the input one, this light will turn on. These two relays are optically isolated. So we have optocoupler here. What it means is that if you want totally to isolate even the power of the relay from the current, from the DC circuit, you can do so. So it makes it safer if you want to isolate the operation of the relay from the circuit. Here's a jumper here for that purpose. So normally when it comes, it is on the left side. So it says JDVCC. So if you're planning to power the relay from the same circuit that receives the signal, just leave it here. So when you connect the 5 volts, the 5 volt also will go from here and energize the same relay. So it will supply the power to the relay from this 5 volts. Of course, it will wait for the signal, but the power will be supplied from this 5 volts. But if you're planning to supply voltage for this separately, you just need to remove this, and then here is the ground, and that's the VCC. So VCC is here, and that's the ground. You cannot connect it here. Okay, so just supply your separate voltage of 5 volts in here. If you're using it for development and test purpose, that's fine, because the amount of current that this draws is very minimal, and it can be handled with the Arduino. Now, about the rating of this, which many people miss, is that you cannot turn on and off a heavy load, let's say, depending on the region. For example, if you are in Asia and Europe, which uses 240 volts, then it cannot be more than 2.5 kilowatt. So what it means is that this, the contact of the relay, can handle up to 10 ampere under any circumstance here. So 10 ampere means if you're using 240 volts, so that's 10 ampere multiplied by 10, just put a zero here, so it will be 2500 watt at 250 volts. And if you're in North America, let's say 120, So that's times 10, 1,200 watts. So it has 5 extra, so 1,250. So remember that. And also in DC, if you're using lower voltages, let's say 30, 26 volts, so that will be 280 or 300 watt. More than that will not be handled by the contact of the relay. It may melt down or malfunction. So keep that in mind. This relay is built, the relay module is built very solid. All the solderings are very good. But be careful when you are connecting this to the AC load. This area should be totally isolated and you should not touch it. Be careful with this because it will be very dangerous. So let me explain the AC bulb here. So this is a table light that is connected to the wall outlet, and then the wire goes and will be turned on. But I have disconnected one of these two wires here. So let me show you. So I've just cut this wire from here. Now this can be connected to the relay. The relay job is to just connect it, so it will be on, and disconnected will be off. I've just twisted them and then put some solder, so this can be inserted into a connector with a screw. So to connect the wires, you just unscrew this and insert the wire here and then tighten it back. I've now connected the two wires of AC bulb in here, on the left side and at the middle one. To explain the DC, so this is my DC motor. The DC motor has two wires. The two wires that goes to the DC are coming. So the positive has gone to the middle one, and then from this side the positive is out. Now I have two wires to be connected to the DC source of this motor, because this is DC, so this will be connected to the DC. And then the other two wires that I showed you before that I cut, one goes to the middle, one to the other side, and then this side just goes to the AC power line if you are connecting an AC. But doesn't matter, you can connect DC or different type of load that you want, as long as it just matches the rating of the relay. Let me explain the code now here. This serial begin inside the setup. The serial begin is to display the text here. So if you don't want to display anything, just remove this or comment this out. Pin 7 is set up as an output. This will be connected to relay 1. And in the pin mode also we say pin 8 of the Arduino will be connected to relay 2. That is this pin. Pin 7 and pin 8 are here. And then we have inside the loop, I've put the original functions here and the text a little indented. So if you want to remove it, these are very safe to be removed. So initially, as soon as the motor, the Arduino starts, it puts this pin 8 low, so which means relay 2 will be off. And also we say pin 8 low. So this, anywhere you see pin 8 low will be printed by this. Here I put print without LN, so this goes in one line, and then I print this one again, and then LN. So these two texts can be displayed in one line. That's why we see all this in one line. So if you want new line, just put LN, that means line new. I don't know how they came, but that's new line. And then, so pin 7 will go high, so pin 8 goes low, pin 7 goes high, and then we wait for 3 seconds. So keep relay 2 off, so that's relay 2, and keep relay 1 on for 3 seconds. So both of them, whatever the status it is, so it will be kept for 3 seconds. And after that, pin, they will be reversed. So pin 7, which was high, will be low, and pin 8 is high, which was low, and it will be for 3 seconds. So you can play with this and can configure it the way that you want for the purpose and application that you are interested. So it can, the load can be connected or be turned on and off based on some temperature, based on some condition, based on some switch. So you can just put F condition, F some voltage is bigger than something or a temperature is higher than something, then turn it on and off. And I have separate video that explains and practically the thermometer with the relay, so you can learn from that one. And also I will put the link at the description as well. Now here is a demonstration. I'm gonna connect it. So when it says pin 8 is high, that's the motor. When it says pin 7 high, that is for the light. As you can see, this is going up and down. If I connect the motor, it makes so much noise. So I just put this so you can see the rotation. And see here, that's the light, and 8 is the motor. And this is also indicating that this is for AC. This was the introduction of how to use the 2-channel 5-volt relay for Arduino to control 2 different loads, such as AC bulb or a DC motor or both of them. Thank you for watching. Please thumb up the video, please share it, and also subscribe to get updates of my upcoming videos. You can get the code by clicking at the link at the description below, or you can go directly to robojax.com/learn/arduino.